How do you get a whole row of seats to yourself on a Virgin Airways flight?
Oh, if you're really fat.
That would, yeah, I think they might be able to get rid of an arm.
But I don't think they'd let you on if you were any fatter.
No, but, like, really fat. Oh, I see what you mean.
Die is the right answer. You'd have to die.
Die!
Yeah.
You can't... you can't make people sit next to the dead. That's the
basically,
truth, isn't it?
I think that would be what it was. And if you're flying, say, London to New York, if you're near enough and someone dies, you'd turn around and all the other passengers go, no, really? That's some consideration. But once you pass that point of near return, as they call it, then there's nothing you can do about it except go on to New York.
But what if the plane's full? Do they keep a row for the dead just in case? And in which case, if they keep a row for the dead, what if two people die?
Exactly.
There's always a row at the back.
An outbreak of sickness.
The crew use it for having a kip. What it means is the crew will then have to be awake.
Yes.
Right. The dead bloke, that'll piss them off.
Does it happen a lot, though?
Oh, now, this is what's interesting. British Airways have about 10 deaths a year in flight.
Well, that food is just...
For 36 million passengers. So if you extrapolate out to the rather amazing 3.5 billion passengers that fly every year, that means there must be around 1,000 deaths a year. And different airlines have different ways of doing it. Singapore Airlines have a corpse cupboard. I don't know why it's funny, but it is. So no one need even know there's a death.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's also Fawlty Towers, isn't it?
Yeah. If I ever die on a plane, I should like to be stored in the overhead lockers.
For the rest of time.
Yeah.
British Airways, however, you get a good deal if you die because you go to first class. Yeah.
Excellent. Yeah. At last.
One long-established steward said, many years ago, we used to give them a vodka and tonic, a Daily Mail and eye shades and tell passengers they were fine. We don't do that anymore. Yeah, I think...
it's bad enough being dead, but having got hold of Daily Mail.
Daily Mail and other newspapers, not just the Daily Mail, when they talk about their circulation, they are also including the newspapers that they give away for free. And so I don't think the airlines or any of those kind of institutions actually pay for the newspapers.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So it's mainly, the Daily Mail is mainly dead people on aeroplanes.
Yes.
But the dead are very, very right-wing.